Dr. Dean, it's good to see you again.
Thanks, Jake, for having me on.
So it seems like you haven't really been enjoying answering these speculative 2016 questions, but you must know by going to Iowa and New Hampshire, you're fueling some of that speculation. Is it possible you're entertaining the thought of running for president?
No, I, you know, at this point, I'm supporting Hillary. The reason I went to Iowa is because Tom Harkin asked me to, and I had a long-standing invitation in New Hampshire with St. Anselm's College, which I've had a long-standing relationship with. So I really do think it's much too early to be talking about who's going to run for president. I know you have to ask those questions or your producer will murder you, but, you know, really and truly, that's not why I'm going to Iowa and New Hampshire.
But just to get it out of the way, you're not ruling it out either.
You know, as you know, in politics, you never say never about anything, and I don't intend to start saying never, but I'm at this point supporting Hillary.
Okay. Let's turn to health care, Dr. Dean. So you have been a general supporter of Obamacare, but you criticized one part of it in an op-ed in the Wall Street Journal, the Independent Payment Advisory Board, what Sarah Palin referred to as the death panel.
Yeah.
It's the group that makes recommendations on what Medicare spending should be on. Before I get to you, the substance of your criticism, which I will get to, I promise, you got a lot of heat from Democratic and from Democrats and from left-leaning columnists and reporters because you work, you do some work for a lobbying firm that has pharmaceutical companies and healthcare clients.
Well, it's a law firm. It's not a lobbying firm. We do
okay.
do some lobbying. I don't do any lobbying. Here's my problem with that. And actually, I think Republicans and Democrats are both guilty of this. In Washington, and the press is guilty of this, too. In Washington, when you say something, when you have an idea, the first point of attack is this guy has a conflict of interest or this woman is taking money. Why can't we have a debate on the merits? I was a little disappointed in the left, in the not for criticizing my views, because although I don't think that the people who criticized me actually liked Obamacare that much, it's because their first thing out of their mouth was this is about you, you're wrong, you're taking money. Why can't we have a debate about ideas in this country instead of what our motivations are?
So let's talk about this independent review board or the death panel, as Sarah Palin referred to it.
First of all, that's a ridiculous statement on Sarah Palin's part. I mean, of course, it's not a death panel. What it is, the concern I have about it, Jake, is that regulations, price controls don't work, and they've never worked. And the Republicans have used them, and the Democrats have used them, going back to Harry Truman and Richard Nixon. They do not work.
Before I let you go, I do want to ask about this. There seems to be a zeitgeist shift when it comes to medical marijuana. And since you are a physician, I wanted to get your view. Dr. Sanjay Gupta here at CNN, he changed his view. He now supports medical marijuana. He says the government has been lying to the public for years about the potential damage. And he says it does a lot of good for people who need that kind of relief and increased appetite and the like. What's your position?
The biggest problem that I have with medical marijuana is the delivery mechanism. I don't know of another drug that we allow to be delivered in what's clearly a toxic way. It is not benign to inhale burning substances, whether it's tobacco or pot or just plain burning paper. Who would deliver something by inhaling smoke into your lungs? I do not have a problem with decriminalizing marijuana. I'm not one of these reefer madness people. But when it comes to medicine, I really don't like hocus pocus. I'm not unwilling to let people use marijuana who failed on all kinds of other treatments. I'm not. But I am unwilling to have the government bless a delivery mechanism, which is nonsense. If you want to use medical marijuana, let's use the active ingredients. Let's not have people inhale it and risk all the damage that causes with that.
All right. Dr. Howard Brush Dean, thank you so much for coming and sharing your views.
Thank you.